Hi, I'm Rob, and today's video is especially for the DeWalt table saw owners, and it's maybe a future problem with your machine. And it has to do with lubrication, or at least the lack of it. And that I want to make you aware of, and that's what I like to show you. So now we are on the other side of the table. And here is the culprit. This is the problem. This is the troublemaker. Here in this aluminum, the thread is going to be stripped away by, of course, a harder threaded bolt. Or here the thread, it's steel. And steel is, of course, harder than aluminum. And this is then not greased by the people, but the glider in the back and the crown wheels, the crown gears. And yeah, that is not such a problem. The biggest problem is this one, and that you should lubricate. Well, I didn't clean it yet, but yeah, like this many times, yeah, it looks my machine. Because I do this, I clean this with a brush every week. So most people, they do the glider in the back, that gliding bar, but the thread, this threaded rod, is way more important. That slides, this has to turn, and many people think that they have to put in here grease, but I wouldn't grease that. Yeah, I don't have dry lube, because you can do it with Teflon. Teflon lube, and that is dry, and then your wood dust doesn't stick to it, and it doesn't get a very strange paste, you know. And in the end, it works a bit like glue, and it will jam up this part here. Maybe you can see that. Maybe I can do it close up. This part, that's a motor part. That's a casting where the motor is situated on. And then you have to renew that whole part. And you have to take the whole sewing machine apart. Only because this thread is worn out. And soon as you don't get it up or down anymore, or the total blade or the total motor goes down and you can't get it up anymore, for sure, here the thread will be gone. This is just a straight hole then. So then you have to pay a lot of money and you have to take all apart. The whole electromotor has to be taken apart. Brushes, everything. So if you keep this well looped, especially with dry stuff, I don't think that you ever will run into that problem. And many times when the machine is 5 years old, on YouTube with table saw problems, you see a lot of videos. And that was the reason why I thought, well, then I want to make the people attentive to it, that this is not so critical, it's more the thread that's critical. Yeah, of course, the choice, how they build it, it's not really great, because for the same price in here, this is then the cast, where the motor is on and everything is on. But if this wears out, you have to renew that whole aluminum part. So why not insert it a bushing with thread? And then you can take the bushing out and renew the bushing instead of that whole part. Well, it is what it is. Also quite important, that is this air vent from the motor. Here are the brushes, and a lot of wood dust gets sucked in, and then they jam up your brushes. So then you get trouble with the brushes. So what I do is, yeah, all every week I put the vacuum on it. Maybe it helps, I don't know, but that's what I do. Well, see what happens.
So the movement what you just saw from the top going down, but only in the downside. It doesn't go to the upside. It only does it by the downside. So I think it's just by the sheer weight of the knob that that thing, and by the vibration, that it goes down like this. But then it doesn't go further. So I think this weight will keep it down. And the difference between the top setting and the down setting is, I think, 1 millimeter. It's probably metric 14, and it has a pitch of 2 millimeter. So one full rotation is 2 mil. So if it does only half a rotation, it's probably 1 mil. But if you want to do a depth cut, yeah, well, you can't miss a mil. You want that it stays in the place. And that is probably so light as that whole system supposed to work. And yeah, there is another problem. You look on top of your table, and if this moves on you for half a turn, yeah, you're not always aware of it, because you look on top of the table, you don't look here. So yeah, then you're off. Well, if I don't want to run it away from me, from the position, I do it just with an elastic band, you see. So yeah, I can attach it on a few places, but then it will stay. But that's in a way how smooth that should work. If I do it on the other side, if it's a bit like this, it doesn't move. It doesn't go like this, you know, but it will go like this. So down it will, but up it doesn't. And this movement, that's already from the first day that it came out of the box. So it came like that from the factory.
Well, I hope it was a clear video. And yeah, maybe you can do something with it for your own machine or whatever. Anyway, I'd like to thank you for watching. And maybe till the next time. Bye-bye.